I feel like every morning it's hard because I wake up and I just think. Keep scrolling through messages because I keep remembering things because, I don't know, I'll like remember something that makes me sad, like look through a message history about it, and then try to figure out like what I did wrong or like what, I don't know, went wrong. But I just feel like ultimately I never felt like I was wanted. And I do know that that might have been on me because I didn't take what he said for what it was. Like, for example, just like him not inviting me to things or like not taking initiative to like spend time with me. And also like him not taking pictures with me or like taking his B-reel with me. And yeah, I knew that I would like kind of make jokes about how he never really wants to hang out with me, or he would, you know, do this thing with this other girl but not with me. And I think a part of me was joking just to like get a reaction for fun, but I think also a part of me really wanted some sort of reassurance that he actually wanted to do stuff with me, and he wanted to hang out with me. And I think I just never got that. And looking back, I think maybe if he did something that I wanted to partake in, like I should have just asked him if I could have gone with him instead of like expecting him to invite me and then not inviting me and then me feeling bad about it and then needing to like distract myself during the time that he's doing that, so I didn't focus on how he didn't invite me, if that makes sense. But I know that if I'm with the right person, then, you know, I wouldn't need to feel like I needed to invite myself, and I would have felt wanted. And I could speculate all I want about why that's the case. Like, yeah, like maybe he just wanted to play volleyball at his level without needing to accommodate me, and maybe all his free time he wanted to just play games or like watch sports or like read about sports or whatever. And yeah, I guess I just wish that instead of me always accommodating him and his life, he wanted to also do the same for me. And a part of me thinks that maybe if I was, you know, more accommodating to him so that we could just spend more time together, then, you know, like things would have been fine. But at the same time, I think I know that inevitably this would have happened because I would just continue to feel like unwanted at some point. And a lot of the times I remember feeling like I would go out and do my own thing and expend my own energy so that he had enough time to kind of like build up his battery. And then by the time that like I would get back, he would have the energy to spend with me, and he would be ready to like actively like be engaged and hang out with me. And I think every time that happened, I was just always like disappointed because I just expected that he would like have missed me and wanted to spend time with me. And sometimes it was true, I guess, but a lot of the times it wasn't, and I just set myself up for disappointment. And maybe it is true, maybe like he is just tired all the time and he is really a grandpa like he says, even though it's kind of hard to believe. But yeah, I think relationships are a lot of energy, and if you feel like you're not getting anything out of it, I can understand why it'd be draining. And I think maybe he just didn't have the energy it took, I guess, to be with me, because I know I'm super draining to a lot of people, or I just have somehow endless amounts of energy. But I feel like I have a high threshold of energy in the first place, but I also think I have this like capability to like push myself to get more if I needed it, especially if I was with somebody who wanted it, if that makes sense. Like, I feel like I can match someone's energy, or if someone else wants to do more, like, I can do more. And I don't know if that makes sense. But I know some people, if their battery's just dead, like, they can't self-charge. They just have to, like, or they can't, like, charge right away in that moment. They have to, like, actually be like, okay, I'm dead. Let me, like, go plug myself in and charge up, and then I'll be ready. Whereas I feel like I kind of have this like self-generator where if I really mentally needed to, I could like be like, okay, let me turn this shit on, and I'll be able to like match the energy of the people around me, if that makes sense. I don't know. So many thoughts, but yeah, over time I think it'll get easier. I don't know. I think I just have to remind myself that like, I'm lucky that our lives did cross paths, and I'm really thankful for the time that we did spend together because it was really fun. And I'm thankful that I learned more about myself, and I learned stuff from him, and there's so much that I have in my life to be thankful for. Yeah, even if like, I feel like I'm just thinking too much or being really dumb or like just like taking so long to get over this. Like, I think it's okay and I shouldn't be so hard on myself. And I know everyone has high expectations for themselves and it's okay to feel this way. I just wish always things would be faster. And yeah, I always feel like I need to learn to be more patient, so maybe this is my time to realize that, you know, things are the way they are. That's okay. Things will pass. There's no need to be mad at myself or, yeah, things taking longer than I'd like.
Covering up the holes. I'll fight for your love, I'll fight for your soul.
Maybe I should have pushed harder to, I don't know, watch his like favorite movies with him, or like cook with him, or like play games with him. But ultimately, if those are things that I didn't want, then like, I don't know what I could have done. I think if he was really excited to do something with me, even if it were one of those things that I wasn't inherently excited to do, I would have loved to do them, and I think I would have had so much fun. And I don't know, I guess we did just want different things. I guess I just wanted him to ultimately want to do things with me. Or at least ask if I wanted to do stuff that he probably assumed I didn't want to do, because I feel like I'm always pretty open to doing anything that kind of makes the people I care about happy. So, yeah, I think one thing that I kept thinking about was how maybe we didn't trust each other enough, and I think that's just both of our insecurities coming to light, where I didn't trust that he genuinely wanted to spend time with me and take his word for the things that he said and try to like put aside how he said things. But I also think that he didn't trust that I wasn't as sad or angry or upset by the things that he did. Like, I felt like he also thought that he was disappointing me in some way, and he felt a lot of guilt, I think. And, like, I don't know, I wish I could have reassured him, but I don't even think reassurance would have done anything for him like it does for me. And I think he thought that I was always more sad than I really was, or more, you know, upset than I really was, or more disappointed than I really was in any situation. And he would always say, like, oh, I sounded so disappointed, or I sounded so whatever, but I really wasn't. I really, really wasn't. And maybe, yeah, over time he just felt really guilty that he wasn't being there for me, but really he was enough. And I don't know, I wish he knew that. Maybe he did just get so discouraged with me, with himself, that it was just too draining for him. And yeah, that's okay. I think maybe we both just needed to trust each other more. I don't know. But in the future, I think I do want to work on trusting that if somebody cares about me, I'm never going to be a burden, and I'm not going to be bothersome. And if I have wants and I have needs, like, voice them, and if they care, then they'll be honest with me and they'll say if I'm a burden or whatever. But I don't want to, like, not give them the benefit of the doubt and assume that they'll deny me of whatever I want. Yeah, fuck. I said I was gonna stop thinking, but clearly I kept thinking, so yeah, I think I should need to get up soon. Okay.
Bye. No, don't come back to me, no. No, don't come back to me. You want the one for me, 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 you.